There are many simple and interesting bodybuilding stunts which can be performed with little or no equipment, and they can be done by anyone, as individuals, in small groups, or in large classes. We'll see them performed under the guidance of an experienced physical instructor. One of the simplest of the muscle-building stunts is push-ups. These can be done by the class, as the instructor counts, or they can be done under the buddy system, with one boy keeping count for his buddy. And, of course, they can be done individually. To get the most out of the exercise, place your hands shoulder-width apart. Keep your head up and your back straight. Lower yourself by bending your arms until your chest touches the floor. Then push up to the starting position. You can see here how push-ups develop the shoulder and arm muscles, especially the triceps. The one-arm dip requires even more arm strength and skill. Spread your legs wide for balance and twist your body so that your weight will come more directly over the arm. Here's the one-arm dip made into a trick, which you can perform on the beach, in the grass, or in the parlor. In doing this measuring worm, the trick is to keep your legs straight when you're moving them, and to hold your head up. The measuring worm is good for muscles in arms and shoulders and abdomen. It also promotes flexibility. Here's a more difficult form, in which both feet and then both arms move together. Another stunt, similar to the ones we've seen, is straddle chins. The supporter, standing, counts the number of straddle chins the exerciser does. The toes of the supporter must be against the outside of the elbows of the exerciser. His arms are locked on his hips. He stands straight and does not lift. The exerciser holds his body in a straight line from heels to head and pulls himself up until his chest touches the supporter's thighs. Straddle chins are especially good for developing the biceps. Another stunt for partners of equal size and weight is the wheelbarrow. The easiest method is for the rear boy to support the front boy at the knees. Supporting the front boy at the ankles is more difficult, but it's a better exercise for developing the abdomen. Here are three things not to do in the wheelbarrow. When you're the front boy, don't put your head down and don't take steps that are too long. When you're the boy in the rear, don't shove. Two other kinds of locomotion are the seal crawl and the crab walk. For the crab walk, keep your hips high and your arms straight. When you run, take short, quick, backward steps. The seal crawl is a little more tricky. Be sure to turn your fingers out to help push yourself forward. Keep your toes extended and your hips down, but not too far down. Your body must form a straight line. Now you're ready to move forward, looking much like a seal. Notice that the toes are dragged along the floor. You can make the seal crawl more difficult by moving both your flippers, or arms, together and clapping your hands before putting them down. Now we're all set for a wheelbarrow relay race, for which a group is divided into teams of equal size. In this case, two teams of four boys each. It's a better game when teams are also matched in athletic skill and ability. The wheelbarrow relay and the same sort of relay using the crab walk or seal crawl is good sport and good fun for any group of boys. Here are some simple stunts which develop various skills. By performing them repeatedly, you'll improve your flexibility, coordination, and balance. The Turkstand is easy. Just keep your arms folded and sit down close to your feet. Lean well forward when you're rising. This is the double heel click. As you jump up, click the heels and let them separate. Do the same as you come down. Watch the double heel click in slow motion. The legs are straight but relaxed. If they are too tense, they won't separate after the first heel click. These boys are doing the top. A strong throw with the arms and a vigorous twist of the head spin you around like a top. Keep your body fairly straight and your arms in close to the body. This stunt carries the appropriate name, jumping jack. Drop to a squat with your wrists crossed. Then don't jump up, but straighten upward with a snap, landing on the heels. Notice that in doing the jumping jack, you keep your hips slightly flexed. The human wicket is a good limbering up exercise and a warm-up for the wicket walk. Place your hands on the floor and put your weight on them. Keep your legs straight and close to your hands as you move out. The wicket walk is a good test of your flexibility. Many people can't do it. The kneeling jump is a test of coordination. Lean forward and combine a forward arm swing with a quick jump and pull your feet under you. The single squat calls for strong legs and a good sense of balance. Nothing but the supporting foot may touch the floor. Use your arms for balance and hold your body as straight as possible in the single squat. To do the human ball, put your arms between your legs and around your ankles. Pull your feet in close, face left, tip over on your right side, roll across your back to the left side with your feet in the air. Three times and you're back where you started. Push with your left knee to return to the sitting position. Make your rolls continuous as you do the human ball. For beginners, mats should be used for the stunts which follow. The knee dip is a trick in which only one foot and knee may touch the floor. Bend your body forward to balance the back leg. Here are two forms of the knee dip. The method to your left is easier and should be learned before you try the one on the right. The slips of paper will be the bait in another balancing stunt known as the fish hawk dive. Again, only one knee and leg touch the floor. Use your arms and free leg to keep your balance. Turn the supporting foot inward and keep your head up. Knee and hip joints are flexed as you pick up the paper. A good stunt for flexibility is the corkscrew. Put your left hand around your right leg, kneel, and reach between your legs to pick up the paper. Several good stunts can be done with wands or any kind of smooth sticks. This one is called thru the stick. Hands behind the back, palms forward. Bring the stick over the head, then right leg around the right arm and over the stick. Don't let go of the stick at any time. Now squat and bring your left hand over your head and pass the stick down across your back. Stand up and step out with your left foot through the stick. This is called the jump stick, but don't try actually to jump over the stick. Just jump upward, drawing your knees up to your chest, and swing the stick under your feet. When you've learned the forward jump stick, try the backward jump. Doing them in rhythm requires that extra little hop between. It takes a partner to do this stunt, which is known as under the stick. Hold the stick with both hands and duck your head under close to your hands. Arch your back and twist around under the stick. Keep a tight grip with your hands and keep your feet as nearly under your hands as possible. The backward bend is another trick for which it's wise to have a buddy stand by at first. This is the way to determine where to hold the stick. With your feet about 2 feet apart, put your hands to your nose with the wand overhead and bend backward. Let your knees and abdomen move forward and keep the stick vertical. Remember, these stunts can be performed with any kind of smooth sticks. However, until you've learned them, it's wise to work on a mat or in the sand or grass. All the stunts which we have seen are easy to learn and easy to do almost anywhere, because they require no special equipment. Try them yourself. When you're alone, when you're out playing with a gang or in meetings of your boys' club or other organized group, they'll help you develop muscle, flexibility, coordination, and balance. And they'll help you pass the time, because these simple stunts are fun.